It has been an insane 24 hours for Ethereum. Not only is it up 11.5% in the last 24 hours, but guys, it's up 30% in the last 7 days. Ethereum crushed through the $3,000 mark, but it didn't stop there. Ethereum has also blasted through both $3,100 and $3,200 without skipping a beat. Currently, as of this moment, we're dancing with $3,300 and trying to set yet another new all-time high in Ethereum. Oh yeah, and Bitcoin's kind of been sleeping a little bit. So where will we go from here? Stay tuned, guys. You don't want to miss this one. Hey, what's up? Jay here, and welcome to Bitcoin Daily, bringing you guys the best tips, tutorials, and ideas to help you guys become profitable and successful investors. The goal of this channel is to empower you guys with the knowledge and resources to take you up to that next level. So guys, make sure to smash that like button. And if you're new here, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and turn on that notification bell. If you have notification bell turned on, let me know in the comments that you're part of the Noti gang. Let's jump into today's video. Alrighty guys, so it was a bit of a choppy weekend, but the trade setups that we gave you on Friday's video came through, guys, and we bagged some profits. Let's go over those trade setups. So the first trade setup that we gave you on Friday's video was the $57,000 entry point, right? So we were looking for a break above $57,000 to enter the trade. So as you guys can see here, this was a point here. Like we said in Friday's video, there's going to be a lot of consolidation in that area, just like there was. But once we got the clean break, boom, it shot all the way up to about $59,000, guys. If you guys use that entry like we told you to and use 10x leverage, you would have done around 35% profits, guys. Look at this huge candle right here. This was a 2% candle. It was a $1,385 move. And then that was followed by another 1.5% candle. In Ethereum on Friday, guys, when we made this video, guys, we were below 2,800. We're around right here. This is where we made the video on Friday, the 30th. This is the 30th right here. Guys, we went, and it feels like it was so long ago now, right? Friday was just 2 days ago. It feels like it was so long ago. Guys, we shot up when we broke through this 2,800 level. Remember, we told you 2,800 was the level we wanted for that breakout. Guys, we broke not only through there, but we went up all the way and broke through $3,000. That was one of the main price targets that I had for Ethereum. Guys, we have officially broken through that price target, and not only through $3,000, we went all the way up to $3,300, which is currently where we're at right now, guys. So if you guys entered the trade way down here at $2,800 and used 5x leverage like we did, you would have done around 90% profit on that trade, guys. So if you guys took any of those trades, congrats, guys. And if you missed out on those trades, stay tuned to the end of this video. We're going to give you guys new trade setups for the rest of the week. For those asking where we trade with leverage, guys, if you've never traded with leverage, first you need to understand what leverage is and how to trade with it. So we have a video for you guys right here, as you guys can see, explained how to trade Bitcoin with leverage. We recommend you guys starting off with that video. After that, I recommend you guys going over to this one right here. This is a Bybit tutorial. Bybit is the platform where we trade with leverage. So I recommend you guys to go over this video. We show you guys exactly how to use a platform from zero to hero. So if you guys want to trade on Bybit, just go down below to the description, scroll down a little bit, and hit where it says trade on Bybit with leverage. They're currently giving away $1,000 in deposit bonuses, plus you can earn up to $600 more in free cash using Bybit. So that's a possibility of over $1,600 for free in bonuses. All right, guys, so let's jump into the Bitcoin analysis. As you guys can see here, currently we had a bull flag formed and then we had that breakout out of there. And then over the weekend, we had the same thing. We had this big move up on Friday. Then we had all this consolidation here, which was basically a replica of exactly what we saw here, right? So we had the same exact pattern and then boom, we had the breakout all the way up to $59,000. Now, you do see some weirdness here. As you guys can see, there's a huge long wick all the way down below 55K. Now, the price didn't actually go here. This was someone either fat thumbed it, or fat fingered it. It's called one of those things where basically they made a mistake and they sold for way lower than what the price was. Or someone is purposely trying to cause some sort of cascade of liquidations here and they were trying to get in cheaper, and it must have worked because the price did go all the way down there. So I'm not sure exactly how that works, but I know that the price was down there for maybe for less than a minute. Literally, it had that sell. There was a cascade of liquidations probably, but luckily it wasn't too many and the price just propped right back up. And we're currently right back above that $58,000 area. And this wasn't the only one. There was another one that went down to about $56,000 or so around the same time period, which was very, very weird as well. So we will keep an eye on this and monitor this situation. Hopefully there's no more of those. In order to prevent any type of stop losses when there's events like this, instead of using last price as what triggers your order, make sure to use something else. You can use like market or one of the other options that they have, depends on what exchange you're trading on. So this one was specifically on Bybit. So if I go here to, for example, BitMEX, you see there's no wick there. So that only happened on the Bybit exchange. Now, as far as how the price is looking, guys, I am still very bullish this week on Bitcoin. I told you guys, after the options expiration date, I was bullish and I was expecting us to test that 60K range again and to possibly set new highs this month in May. You guys can see here that we did get rejected at that 59K level, but I am expecting us to go back up there and not only break it, but then go and test that 60K range as well. That is what I'm going to be expecting over the next few days, possibly even the next few hours. Now remember that at 60K, there was a lot of resistance before. You guys can see over here, over here, and even here it was a support. So we have to watch that area as we've been rejected a bunch of times there. So there could possibly be another rejection there that sends the price back down to around the $59,000 to $58,000 area. But once we break above that 60K level, we should really, the only resistance left should be possibly 62,000, as you guys can see here, which was a previous all-time high. And after that, we should be free all the way up to 65,000. There should be nothing else after 62,000 as a hard resistance. That next one should be that 65K range. If we break 65, we could potentially see the $70,000 mark for the first time ever for Bitcoin. Now, in the event that we do see any type of pullbacks here, we should be looking at that $56,000 range as a support here. As you guys can see, it was a really stable support there. So I don't mind looking for an entry at that range. Also around that 55 to 54K range is going to be the very next support if this one were to not hold for any reason, as there was also a lot of activity in this range. So I'm expecting one of those two levels to be able to hold the price up in the event where there's a scenario where we go down for some reason. Now, of course, we could definitely post another bull flag kind of like this one. So we could possibly form something like this where it's a channel like that. But it's kind of a weird bull flag because look how short it is. I don't know. We're currently in that channel. So I'm looking for a break to the upside here where we can test that 60K range. So we'll be monitoring that as well throughout the week. In Ethereum, guys, you guys can see this clear, This is a daily chart, guys. Look how many green candles in a row. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 green days in a row. And just to keep it going, today it printed a 11% move up, guys, in Ethereum. So we're currently at 3288, and we're dancing right there with 3300, like we said earlier. Currently on the week, we're up about 20%. On the month, we're up about 53%. And then the last 3 months, guys, we're over 100% in profit in Ethereum. Now, a break above 3,300 should lead Ethereum, I would imagine, up to 3,500. Why would it stop at 3,400, right? Like, there's nothing for it there. Might as well just go a little bit more up to 3,500. And we're right there at the halfway point between 35 and 4K. Now, things to note here, we are overbought, okay, guys? So make sure to note that we're overbought right now on the daily time frame. You can see here, last time we were overbought, that's when we had that pullback. Before that, if we scroll a little bit further, we were overbought over here. Let's see what happened when we were there. So we were overbought for a while there before a pullback eventually came. You can see that the levels there, it was about around that 90 range, 88, 89. Currently, we're sitting at about 80, I would say. So, I mean, we could possibly continue to go upwards, but remember, guys, that prices don't only go up. I know it might seem like it when you've had however many days in a row. I think it was 10 days in a row that I counted. But it might seem like prices only go up in Ethereum. But there are drawbacks and pullbacks here. As you guys can see here, 21% pullback here. If we look at the daily, we're also clearly in the overbought region. And again, if you look back, last time we were overbought, we had to pull back. When we were overbought over here, we consolidated mostly. We didn't really pull back like we did here. We mostly consolidated there until it kind of reset the RSI and we were able to continue up. So I'm expecting some sort of consolidation or pullback. I don't expect anything major, but something, it's not going to just keep going up. So be prepared for that. Make sure that you're taking profits on any short-term trades. We could see a possible pullback and it retests, you know, 3,200, 3,100. Maybe even it could kind of consolidate its way back to 3,000 before continuing up. But I mean, before it does that, we could possibly test that 3,500 level. So that's not out of the question. We could definitely break out, hit that 35 range, and then kind of consolidate its way back a bit before continuing on its way up. So again, I'm still very, very bullish on Ethereum. I definitely think that we might be able to see 10K by the end of this year. Remember, there's an upgrade coming soon in the summer for Ethereum, which should also continue to push the price up, as Ethereum is going to start burning coins once that upgrade happens. Alrighty, guys, so next we're gonna jump into the trade setups that we're going to be watching for the rest of this week. You guys don't wanna miss this part, guys. We've been hitting on almost all of these every single week. Now, in order for me to give you these trade setups, guys, you must like the video and be subscribed to the channel. So go ahead, I'm gonna give you guys a few seconds to make sure that you're liking this video and subscribing to the channel. And as soon as you do both of those, the trade setups will appear magically. Are you ready? All righty, guys, we're gonna like the video at the same time on three. Are you ready? 1, 2, 3, boom. Here are the trade setups for those who liked the video. For those who did not like the video at this point, you're getting a different scenario, a different video here where I'm going to show you fake trade setups. So good luck with that. All right, guys, so the first price that we're looking at here is pretty much right where we're at. We're at that $58,000 mark. Now, as you guys know, there is consolidation here. So you have to kind of be careful. You kind of have to either have a wider stop or a tighter stop so that you minimize those losses and make sure that you're taking profits as soon as you're in profit, right? So 58,000 is gonna be that first level where we're looking to enter trades and trying to catch it as it rides it back up to that $59,000 area. And then above that, of course, we're looking at 60K. 60K is gonna be a main level. If we break 60, we expect it to go up to 62. a break of 62, we're expecting 65. So those are the breakout trades that we're looking for. As far as a pullback, if we see any bounce entries, is going to be towards this 57K area. So 57K is going to be a good range to look for a bounce entry, meaning that when it bounces back up, that's when we're setting off that buy order. We're not setting it off when it drops down. In Ethereum, as you guys can see right now, we're setting new all-time highs. So the entry I was going to give you guys was above 3,300. Because we're already above 3,300, it can't be a breakout play anymore. But what we can tell you, it will be a bounce back, bounce entry play. So in the event that Ethereum goes back down to 3,300, we will be using that as a bounce entry. In the event that it continues up as it is right now, we're going to look for $3,400 as that first entry, and the second breakout entry is above $3,500. So $3,400, $3,500, two breakout entries there. We expect a break of $3,500 could potentially lead us up to that $4,000 mark. Now, in the scenario that we start consolidating downwards or setting up some sort of bull flag, we will be looking for entries at $3,200 and $3,100 and, of course, $3,000. I don't see it going under $3,000 for any reason, as at least not this week. I don't see it doing that. You know, things can always change, of course. But those are the three pullback entries that we will be looking at. $3,300, $3,200, $3,100, and $3,000. We're interested in entering all of those as a bounce back entry. Alrighty, guys. So we covered the trade recap from the weekend. We did an analysis on both Bitcoin and Ethereum and gave you guys some trade setups to make some profits this week. So guys, make sure to like the video if you haven't yet. And if you're new here, guys, make sure to hit that subscribe button, guys. Turn on the notification bell so you know every time we post up a new video. Thank you guys so much. Let's have an amazing, profitable week. I will see you guys on tomorrow's video. As always, peace and love.